Well, to find out how exposed Asia is to the European Union's fiscal problems, let's get a view on that. Joanna Chua is Chief Economist Asia Pacific at Citi and joins us now live from our Hong Kong studio. Joanna, I'm interested in one of your predictions, which is that you believe there will be limited spillover impact from the EU to Asia. Heightened risk aversion might be one of those key fallout issues. But the question I have is, why can we ring-fence Asia to an extent? Because if Europe does pull back on its fiscal spending, then surely that will impact Asian exports.
Okay, well, what we're looking at is when we're analyzing is we're only focusing on the peripheral euro area countries that are having these fiscal problems. So if the problems remain in peripheral countries contained within Greece, for example, or say Portugal, then if you look at Asia's exposure, for example, on trade linkages to a few of these European countries, it's actually very, very small. So if you combine Asia's exports to, say, Portugal, Ireland, Greece, and Spain together, they only comprise something like 0.4 to 2% of total exports, or maybe 0.1 to 1.3% of GDP. Now, of course, if this problem becomes a much larger problem in euro area, then that would have a much bigger impact, but we're not assuming that.
Joanna, it's Maura here in Singapore. What about the impact through currencies? I mean, with the dollar gaining strength right now, are we seeing weakness in the Asian currencies? And if so, won't that actually help Asia in terms of exports?
Sure, sure. At the moment, given the way assets are behaving, we're having an overall risk aversion. So euro dollar and dollar Asia are very highly correlated. Now, to a certain extent, you know, the impact of Asian currencies haven't been as dramatic to have very, very significant, meaningful impact on growth. But we do think that Asia is probably not going to have a huge, huge volatility. I mean, the impact of Asian currencies on this risk aversion should not be too dramatic, given that the current Asian countries actually have a very, very strong external liquidity position. So the ability of the region to withstand volatility in capital flows is actually fairly strong, and that should cap some of the volatility because central banks are in a good position to intervene if things got out of hand.
The concern with Europe is that with all this debt that has to be that was taken on by governments to help stimulate the economies, they're in a position where they can't actually pay off that their burden right now. Could we see any Asian economies running into a similar problem? And I guess I'm thinking of Japan first and foremost, but could there be other Asian countries that may have trouble paying back?
See, you know, I think there should be a very strong differentiation of credit and fundamental situation in Asia versus what's happening in Europe. Yes, Japan has very large debt and large fiscal deficit, but we know that Japan also has high domestic savings, so their net debt is actually lower than what the gross debt would imply. But if you look at Asia, for example, I think there's two very key differences in Asia versus, for example, what's happening in Europe. You know, first, real growth rates in this region are far higher vis-a-vis real interest rates than when you compare it to most of Europe. So that's why the fiscal flexibility in this region is actually a little bit stronger. Take, for example, the case of India, where debt to GDP and fiscal deficit to GDP in fiscal year 2010 is probably sort of comparable to some of those troubled European countries. But again, you know, we are expecting India is going to be able to grow about 8.4% in fiscal year 11. And when you compare that to its real interest rates, India could actually run a small primary deficit and debt to GDP shouldn't go up a lot. The other second very important difference between Asia and sort of some of the European countries is that for a lot of the major Asian countries, most of the government debt are funded domestically in local currency. Take, for example, India or Malaysia, where, say, 96.5% to 97% of public debt are actually funded by residents or from domestic sources in local currency, which is a very, very different situation in Europe, where, for example, Greece, something like over 80% of public debt are actually held by non-residents, and they are denominated in euro, which is a local currency that Greece doesn't have direct control over because of the monetary union. So again, there's very, very different situation when you look at some of the fiscal challenges in Europe than really what's happening in Asia. And I think Asia fiscally is in a much more flexible and stronger position.
Okay, Joanna, we'll get back to you in just a moment there. Joanna Chua, Chief Economist Asia Pacific at Citi.